How's it going out there, everybody? As always, I am the Wolf Knight, and welcome back to Stardew Valley, continuing from where we left off yesterday. Finished watering all my crops, and now look. We have another bundle of hot peppers all ready to go, and as you can see, our wild seeds are ready to go. Which is very excellent. We will sell these, and then we will harvest all of these. This is over 100 things to harvest right here. Gotta love it. We should have enough to, we should have enough day... Well... It takes about 7 days for these to fully grow. Five, six, seven, eight, nine. So, yeah, we won't have enough days left to grow another 2 sets. We will make another 100 of these. Rehoe the ground. Or unhoed it. See if we have an... We'll go for 90 right now, just to make sure. Well, hold on. 2 fertilizer. Oh well. It's fine. We will get all these planted up anyway. Even if we didn't have enough fertilizer. Okay, yeah, we do need another 10. And now we will take all these. Oh yeah, as you can see, we made about 6,000 something from this crop of blueberries we harvested last round, yesterday. We also, that also gave us enough to get to quality sprinklers. Which is excellent. We do have the forage done, right? Actually, I thought we had an extra 30 from doing that, but I guess I thought I did. Oh well, we will now take the rest of these and sell them. That's gonna net us a nice chunk of change. Get the rest of these watered up. Don't miss that. Yeah, having this steel watering can makes watering all these so much easier. It's still a big drain on our stamina. But darn it, I keep missing. And you Sorry if I'm not talking that much. It's hard to find stuff to talk it's hard for me to find stuff to talk about. Because I'm not really much of a talk person. You know, I could talk to you when it comes to talking about normal stuff. I can't really talk that well about normal stuff, like, you know, going out and doing stuff. I'm a gamer by heart. You know, it's what I love, it's what I do. I mean, it comes to games, I can talk as much as you can about games, maybe even more so. Now, get all these. All watered up. But yeah, that's an interesting question. What was y'all's first game y'all ever played? You know, what was the first game you got your hands on? And you just absolutely loved it. Let me rephrase that. What was the first game you ever played, you know, that started you down the path of being a gamer? And then, what is the first game that you absolutely just fell in love with? My first game, I remember it. I remember it very well. It was, the old Mario game, Yoshi's Island, you know, where you took control of the Yoshis and you had baby Mario and whatnot on your back. That was my first game. And you won't believe how young I was when I played that. I was 3. Yes, I was 3 when I played my first video game. And from that moment on, I've been a gamer ever since. Now, the funny thing about that is, being 3, I remember sitting there watching my brother and my cousin just playing it. They get to this one boss they just couldn't beat. If you play, if you played Yoshi's Island or are playing it, you'll know the boss. The black, I guess you could say, bird or penguin that's on the, like, little planet. And they were just having so much trouble trying to beat this thing. They just kept dying over and over again, burning through their lives. So they decide to pause it and go and, like, blow off steam. You know, they were both playing it. They would both play a few lives and hand it to the other one. So, after they probably went through maybe 75% of their lives, they paused the game, went in the living room and take a break. I went over there, grabbed the controller, and within like 5 minutes, just as I beat the damn penguin, they come in there and see me with the controller and they're like, "No!" Because they think a 3-year-old is gonna just mess up their game and just has probably cost them a bunch of lives. And they're just completely like, "What the?" Surprised that I managed to beat this thing when they couldn't. They did beat the game. You know, but it wasn't until after I'd beaten it. So, because of that, I've always said I'm the better gamer than them. But to this day, they both deny it. I mean, my brother and my cousin, they're not that big gamers. My brother, he still plays games, but he doesn't play them as, like, he's not a hardcore gamer. He's a mild gamer. You know, what he plays is, you know, sports games. Like, he plays sports and racing games. You know, that's what he plays. You know, football games. You know, he's played a couple of other different sports games as well, but you know, one thing he'd always want me to play him in the football games, and I'm not good at the sports games, so I always lost by a lot. But there's one thing I did when I'd play him, I'd get to like fourth down, and he'd be like, "Look, you're gonna have to punt it. There's no way you're gonna score." One thing I'd always did that he hated was I would do a fake pass, and always manage to throw and run for a first down. That always ticked him off. Because I mean, I tried to do it as much as I can, but I could only ever do it like once every turnover. Like, I'd go the four downs, then throw for the first down, and then try to do that again, but I would fail, and he would get the ball again. So, but it was always funny. I mean, he would get so pissed at that. It's like, why didn't you throw the ball? You weren't gonna win. I don't know what you were gonna. You weren't gonna get anywhere. It was like, I'm thinking in my head. It's still funny though. Ah, lightning rod, wild seeds, fall, and a warp totem beach. Excellent. Woo! Look at that money. Most of it came from spice berries. Yeah, most of it is from spice berries. You see, we didn't have no grapes there. We only got enough grapes to make the 100 seeds. What's the weather like today? Sunny. And they're somewhat annoyed. Crop of tomatoes. Man, we are not stopping in the money today. We won't get a huge payday from these tomatoes, but we will get a nice payday. Sorry about that. All we're missing is a melon. And, you know, by the time when our melons get done, we should get enough for to be able to complete the gold quality crops. The gold quality crop for the melons and quality crops. And we will be able to complete the bundle for this year as well. So that'll be something. I hate that a lightning rod struck this. You know, what is it to make some lightning rods? Iron, quartz, bat wings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Take that. Don't I have some... I was pretty sure I had some refined quartz. Oh well. Maybe we'll get some smelting real quick. We will make several lightning rods to litter around our base so we don't have to worry about anything any more lightning trying to strike our crops. Oh, we need to get that maple syrup so we can complete a bundle. I see you. Just some stone. Always hate that. You find some worms and it's just stone or something like that. It should be done pretty soon. Because I don't think it takes that long for refined quartz. There they are. One, two. Three. There. Set that there. We'll set you there. And we will set you there. Get all this watered up. Hopefully by the time we finish up all this, that quartz will be done. We can make another 2 lightning rods. Then hopefully we get a storm coming soon. That way we can get some battery packs. Because we need those for iridium sprinklers. And there we go. Excellent. I think we need a charcoal kiln. Gold bar, wood. Yeah, we'll make a... we'll make a charcoal kiln. Because we need it. Because we are running out of coal. Alrighty. Got all that taken care of. Put those back in there. Yeah, we have one piece of coal left. So. Alright guys, I think that'll about do it for this episode of Stardew Valley. Thank y'all for joining me. Please be sure to leave a like and comment. And subscribe if y'all like it enough to see more. And thank y'all for joining me. Goodbye.